All right, it is live now.
It's gonna let you start. Right.
We're early. Yep, here we go. Countdown. Yeah.
Hello, skateboarders. Welcome to TSM Live Show, Season 3, Episode 6. I'm your host, Tommy Zam. We have a great show for you. This episode is feature skaters Joshua Silva, music by Gene, interview with Dave, a.k.a. Devo Bohack. Right after this Coffin Crew commercial, we're going to be sitting down with feature skater Joshua Silva. You guys ready to get this show started? What's up, Josh? How you doing?
What's going on, Tommy?
Not much, buddy. How's everything going for you?
Just hanging out. Typical day.
Hell yeah, hell yeah. How's the weather up there in Massachusetts?
It's like in the low 60s some days, and then it goes up to like the high 70s.
Oh, here, man. Now it's fucking raining like crazy.
It's terrible.
Little delay here. I do apologize on that. It's live stream technology, you know. But you get this show started?
I'm ready, man.
So tell me a little bit about you.
Well, I'm 29. I have an 8-year-old son and a 3-year-old stepson. And I just skate and work, man. That's it.
hell yeah, dude. And so, like, tell us a little bit about, like, growing up in your hometown. Like, where you was actually from? You said New Hampshire or?
New Bedford.
Tell us a little about, like, what was it like growing up in New Bedford?
Yeah, some days are better than others. It's pretty cool if you just keep to yourself. It depends on the area that you live into. Like, where I grew up is kind of shitty. But other than that, it's straight, man. I don't know.
Hell yeah. And what got you into skateboarding?
Honestly, my cousin had a board, and like he was like skating all the time, and I was like, all right, man, I want to do that, and that was it. Done after that.
And then, do you remember your first trick?
Maybe like an ollie off like a curb or something. Actually, no, I do remember. We had this kicker ramp set up, and it was like a kicker ramp, a plastic flat piece, and then we stuffed the flat bar underneath the flat piece so we could ride up the ramp over onto the flat and grind the rail like without having to like ollie onto it. And that was it.
Mm-hmm. Hey, that sounds pretty fun, dude. I think my first trick was learning power slides.
Yeah, that's rad.
Yeah, definitely power slides are pretty cool, I guess, back in the day. I mean, I'm a little older, you know, but back then it was, power slides are pretty cool. But did you like go to like local skate shops to buy your boards, or is there like cool like local skate shops around your area or what?
Yeah, we got Solstice. That's like down the street from my house. I don't know if you guys know of that shop or what, but that's just where I've been going since I figured out that that's where you go to buy boards.
That's awesome. And then that's what got you more and more into skateboarding?
Yes and no. I mean, it was more like middle school and like elementary, meeting up with like homies that skated and try to like learn from them and whatnot.
Okay, cool. And then what was it like skateboarding in your hometown? I mean, did you get like, you know, like were like people like looking down at you when you're growing up skateboarding, or did the people accept you or what?
Nah, people hated. That was before it was accepted, though, man. You know what I mean? Now everybody wants to dress like a skateboarder and wear fucking Thrasher tees and this and that, dude. We used to get picked on, man.
Yeah, yeah. I remember that days, man. Get picked on, dude. Used to get picked on all the time. The rednecks, everybody, the cops, everything.
Oh, yeah. The cops are pretty heavy over here. It's kind of a pain in the ass.
You know, nowadays it's crazy because skateboarding is so accepted. Like you said, everybody's rocking Thrasher shirts and, you know, looking like. Yeah. What's your feel on that?
You can do what you want, man. You know, it's like, I ain't the fucking boss. But I think it takes a little more of the originality out of us being like our own thing,
yeah.
Which is like everybody else trying to be something they're not.
Yeah, yeah, definitely, definitely. Agree with you, man. Do you like prefer skate more parks or more street?
I like my park, but most of the time, dude, if we can get into the streets, we're in the streets. Like I said, this morning I was there fixing up one of those street spots, like first thing, because once we like rub bricked it and clear coated it and waxed it and turned it into something that we could skate every day, it's like, now I don't even want to go to the park. It's like we just meet up there and that's where we're at skating the whole time. So.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. What's your park to go to?
If you go on my Instagram, you'll see it's we have this DIY spot underneath the bridge, and that's like our go-to. It's like fucking like 5 minutes from my house, and I can literally just skate to it.
And I suppose that's pretty rad to have a park like 5 minutes from your house. You know what I mean? You just wake up, shower, shit, smoke a blunt, and go right to the park.
Yeah, most of the time I don't even shower, man. I throw the pants on from yesterday and fucking go.
Hell yeah. And then who are your sponsors?
Right now I'm riding for Aaron's brand, which is like the distribution. So it's Midnight Hardware, BB Risers, Sparrow Bearings. I'm getting wheels from Underground Wheels. Mark S Grip. It's Static Age. It's a clothing company that's like homie based. And I think that's it. If I'm forgetting any of you guys, my fault, man. I'm not looking at my phone.
It's all good, brother. Do your thing, man.
I think that's it.
Nah, that's sick, dude. So Mark S Grip, that's out of here in San Diego, right?
I think it was originally based here in Mattapoisett, in like my area, and then I think Leb and Alo and Nick moved to San Diego, and it just blew up over there. So all my dudes, they hooked me up real well. San Diego? I appreciate all of them.
Do you make a trip out here to San Diego?
Yeah, once or twice a year, I like to go out and like spend like a week or two, or depending on what work allows me to do and whatnot. But other than that, I mean. Usually just go, you know. I love being out there.
Hell yeah, yeah. It's great weather out there, man. It's great food, great weather, and
yeah, go down Ocean Beach, man.
It's
hit
pretty
the
cool
strip.
I like San Diego, woo! Man. Definitely 100%. And what is your daily life like? Like when you wake up in the morning till you go to bed, what's your whole life like?
I usually wake up, take out my dog so she doesn't shit in the house, and then I go I'll like do my morning stuff, you know what I mean? Like typical shit, and then go to work, get out of work, and then first thing I'm doing is like hitting up the boys, see where we're going, what we're doing, and then go skate for a little bit, come home, spend the night with my kids, and then play Skater XL until I pass out.
You like that game?
Dude, that game is unreal.
Who's your skater?
Myself.
Oh, so you can make your own self on there? Like you can like totally everything?
Yeah, you can make your own character. So, but if I'm not doing that, I'm riding with Evan Smith.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Hey, that's a good choice right there, definitely. And you just gave us a video, man. Tell us about this video we're about to watch.
Honestly, it's funny, man, because like from talking to you guys, like we had a couple things filmed prior to that, but like having like a set date and time that it needed to be done, like really put the fucking fire up my ass. and we just nonstop filmed for it. And what, I think 2-3 days ago, I sent you it, something like that, dude. It was like last minute trying to get that ender.
Shit, I'm ready to check out that ender. Well, you ready to check out this video?
Hey, I'm ready, man.
All right, dude. You guys, let's check out Joshua Silva's video. Here it comes.
So therefore, brothers and sisters, you got to make up in your mind. Are you going to trust God? Are you going to trust in cash money? Because you cannot go to war against God. Chasing the cat's money, brother. Sometimes your idol become the Lord.
I used to see niggas on TV, man. I used to be like, yo, niggas so blessed, you know what I'm saying? I had that opportunity, you know what I'm saying?
Maybach music.
I grew up on that cash money. Bling bling was well known to flash money. Hit the liquor store after my Vic Authority. Quick to switch a bitch up, pick up me a thicker shorty. Pistol on me, nigga, ain't no picking on me. We veterans, so it's better if you go get your army. A thug holiday is where your body lay. Me and Trick Daddy come from a common place. So us getting money, that's just a conversation. It's so hard staying rich and miss the confrontations. Cigars in the Oval Office, Ronald Reagan. Hug Barack Obama, whisper assalamu alaikum. Live for the moment, die for the streets. Bible on the dash, kilos on the seat. I used to see you niggas on my TV screen and wonder what was life like, was it all a dream? And then I met you out on Live Nation dates. Came to the realization that your watch was fake. Damn. You nearly broke my heart. I really thought you niggas really owned them cars. I used to look up to you, nigga. Hard to point a finger when you live a life of sin. I'ma bring my niggas with me if I lose or win. Bought a fleet of cars, let the bitches tag along. This little thing of ours, not the ones to tag along. Omer to the cold, met ball parties with Vogue. Still blowing thick smoke while you powder your nose. Set your head rush until the day the feds rush. That's when you niggas wish you put your bread up. Lease whips, bad blood, that shit'll sink ships. Fast money coming slow, you better think quick. Rap game, so much fuck shit done. That's why this 45 in my truck fit trunks. Fuck a skateboard, I went and got a Wraith, boy. Catholic record labels, niggas getting raped, boy. Birdman's a priest, moans in his synagogue. Publishing is a sin, repent, forgive me, Lord. Shots fired, home invasion out on Palm Ave. Red beam detonators, who the bomb now? Look you in your eyes, nigga, before I say goodnight. And pray that Manny Fresh will get to see the light. Damn, I'm stunned, I love you, nigga. Hate it came to this.
Maybach music.
You stole them boys' pub and bought a foreclosure. Scott Storch demons in it, which is more poison. I handed over records, never charged a coin. But since the sentiment, I'm talking all along. All Miami issues, Rose and perform. Same way Big Ducky do for me in California. Never slipping, got relationships with the trillest niggas. Tony Draper, Jay Prince.
Yo, that was sick, Josh. Yeah. Hell yeah. That was dope as fuck, brother.
Thank you.
Tell us about that ender.
Honestly, that was a pain in the ass. we were like getting the boot, and the dude was like trying to like kick us out. And I was like, dude, like just hook me up. He was like, all right, I got to go do a lockout. And when I come back, you guys like better be gone or whatever. And I was like, all right, so fucking I give it another go, and I got fucking dropped because I was like panicking because I'm like, shit, I'm not gonna be able to come back here for a while. And so I ended up falling, and then I got back up, and my homie was like, dap me up, and was like, yo, you got this shit. And then I ended up just sticking it, and I was like, all right, fuck yeah, let's get the fuck out of here.
Hey, it was fucking dope, man. That part was that was sick, dude. That was clean, man. Definitely is.
I wanted to like shout out my filmer too, because it wouldn't have been possible without him, and it wouldn't have been possible without the wife either. Mary, I know you're watching, and thank you.
Hell yeah. Thank you, filmer, for doing that, man. Couple more questions. I have, like, any shout out or anything you want to say to anybody?
Just my lady, man. That's it.
But. Hell yeah. And one last question before we take off. Do you want to – anything you want to say to the upcoming skaters that are coming up? Like, anything special you want to say to them?
Dude, just do what you want to do, man. Don't let anybody try to stifle you. Otherwise, you'll literally go nowhere.
Hell yeah, dude. That's tight, man. I like that, man. Hey, Josh, man, thank you so much for being on the show. Apologize on this delay thing, technology stuff. What can we do, you know? And hey, man, cool, man, I'm so proud of you, dude. You're fucking killing it, and keep on doing what you do, man. And hey, one more thing, where can people follow you on Instagram?
Joshua Satan Silva.
All right, guys, go follow him, dude. Definitely, dude's fucking kills it. Watch all his videos, man. Josh, thank you so much for coming on the show. And let's check out this commercial from Bones Bearings. And right afterwards, Gene coming up performing. Thanks, Josh.
Peace out, man. Fuck. Fuck. It's sticky.
Gene, how you doing?
I'm good, Tommy. How are you?
Good. We got a little delay, so, you know, I think with all the storm out here and on the in Florida, we got some little delay over here, you know?
No problem.
So, Gene, tell the audience a little bit about you, man. What, you know, let them know who you are and where you're from.
Well, I'm a musician from Canada. I live outside of Toronto in Ontario, and I've been putting out music for my whole freaking life. And I have a new record out. So it comes out October 9th, and that's why I'm here today.
Hell yeah. And what got you into the music?
I got into it when I was so little. So I think I always sang. And then when I was really little, it was kind of like musical theater. And then, you know, you get into like more teenage years and it's just more rock and roll, right? So it all took a hard turn around around high school, and that was the end of it for me.
Oh, hell yeah. And then what kind of music do you play? I mean, what do you consider your music? Is it like punk, or is it like rock, or is it like poppy, or what?
I'd say, I mean, rock, alternative rock, pop, I guess. It's a little quirky as well, which isn't really a genre, but you know, let's just call it rock. It's just a little bit easier.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely, definitely. And you gave us what are you going to play up for us on this show?
I did. We did a live pre-record of the first single off the record called Deep End. And I chilled it out. The recorded version is a little peppy, but this year just blows. So it's a little less peppy than it was in 2019. So a bit more chilled out version, but we did that one. And then we did another song off the record called For Your Love. And it's just a little bit more of a straight up rock record. I had to pick and choose because I had to play the third instrument.
Yeah,
I was just going to say, fuck, we keep talking at the same time. Goddamn fucking 2020. You go.
You got it, girl. I'll sit back.
Usually when I play live, when the world is normal, I don't play and sing live. I just sing because I always fuck up when I'm playing the instrument and singing. I'm just like too panicky of a human. So this pre-record, I was forced to play the bass and to play the acoustic guitar while I sang, which is just not cool. But, you know, you got to do what you got to do.
Hey, I'm ready to check it out. I'm ready to see you jam out. So let's check this out, Gene. Let's hear your performance.
Oh, thanks for having me, Tommy.
No problem, girl.
Deep in love, though, hold it on, we can't should've said no. Put the soul, voices.
Yeah, Gene, that was sick, girl.
Thanks.
Killed it, man. Killed it. I liked it, man. Definitely good song, man. I mean,
thank
definitely
you.
Really good. You coming from Canada, I mean, like, do you feel like it's harder to promote your music and stuff in America, or is it about the same?
I'd say it's about the same. When you're like, I don't have a record label, so I sort of feel like without a label, things are just tricky right across the board, you know? So Canada has its ways with what it likes, I guess, maybe the same with every country, I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. I would say it's hard across the board if you're indie.
How do you come up with your lyrics?
I don't know. I think it's a little more stream of conscious sometimes. Like, it's just like, sometimes someone will ask me what a song's about, and it's sort of like, sometimes it's just more abstract, arty shit, right? Like strings of words that sound cool together. Like, it's like making a necklace, not necessarily like telling a story. But then there's other songs where it's more pointed, right? More like a story, more like it's specific. So it kind of depends on the tune, I guess. But for the most part, I fucking really love words, and I just love trying to find cool combinations and just interesting words out there that maybe haven't been sung that much, you know?
Hell yeah, that's awesome, man. I mean, I don't know if I could ever be a singer, because I mean,
you should try, Tommy.
Nah, dude, I don't know.
Come
man.
On, man. You can try right now, probably.
No. Dude, I think everybody would run if they heard my voice.
Like, well, yeah, you should see me skateboard.
Oh, really? I would love to see that.
No. Never. Never skateboard.
Never. Hell yeah. Well, Gene, thank you so much for being on the show, man. And you have such a beautiful voice. And, you know, I mean, like, you're killing it. I'm so proud of you, dude.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
FaceTime Griffin Gas.
Yo, what up?
Strip on what I got.
No way, they're in.
Beer gas.
Wow.
Malink with the boys, Carol.
Will you
coming?
Send those to my crib? Will you send me a photo real quick, too?
I'll send you a photo right now.
All right, cool. Thank you. Later.
Fuck. Shit.
Rick. Rick! Rick!
Call from Mike Carroll.
Rick said he's gonna link up. How long? I'm trying to go eat.
Do you know Rick? Could be a while.
Oh shit, there he is! Oh,
no man. Way!
Oh!
Yeah, what up?
What's up? Damn, you brought the shoes? I thought Carol was gonna lose these.
Yo, let's roll, these guys are hungry.
Alright, for sure.
Yeah, dude. Pure gas.
What's up, Dougie? Thanks for having me.
Hey, no problem, dude. I guess technology, man. That's all I can say.
Yeah, I know. It's crazy times.
Yeah, I know. Well, we're still learning this live stream stuff, so I think we're getting used to it a little bit. You know, I had to switch it off a little bit. You know, internet's being weird, so don't ever use Spectrum, man. They suck. They might get mad at me for saying
yeah.
They suck, dude.
Yeah, I got AT&T. It's not too bad, so.
Oh, man, Spectrum's the worst, dude. So I had to just get off my computer and jump on my phone real quick because it was so bad, dude.
Yeah, I noticed, like, your image is, like, a lot, like, clearer.
Yeah, definitely.
You should work. That's all that matters.
Hey, we got to run Greg Ab everything, you know.
Yeah.
Well, cool, Debo. So let's get into this, man. Tell us a little bit. Skaters know who you are, but other people who are watching might not know who you are. Tell us a little bit about you.
Yeah. Well, my full name's Dave Bohack. I'm from Howell, New Jersey, 25 years old, and just I moved to LA like I think almost 4 years ago. Yeah, in April it'll be 4 years, and then just trying to make it happen, man. Just trying to, you know, pursue that dream of that, you know, being a professional skateboarder. Mm-hmm. And just trying to enjoy life and be happy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely.
That's it.
And where'd you grow up at, actually?
I grew up in Howell, New Jersey, but I grew up skating like Philadelphia and New York and stuff like that. Like it's only like an hour or so drive from like right where I'm at. So me and my cousins or the homies or whatever, you know, take the bus up to New York if we didn't have, well, when we didn't have cars at the time, but once we got cars, obviously it was a lot easier, but
yeah,
that's it. You know,
what was it? I mean, where is that where you basically grew up? I mean, you grew up skating there, but I mean, like, do you remember how you got into skateboarding?
Yeah, I started skating when I was about 5 years old. My cousin Timmy, well, like, I lived on a farm in Howell, actually. It was like my grandmother's farm. And then like my cousin ended up, there was these three houses on the farm, but like my cousins lived across the street and then my grandma lived across the other way. So, and then, but my cousin Timmy started skating from his homie Adam that lived down the street. And then I always wanted to be like my cousin Timmy because my brother was kind of a dick at the time. He never really wanted me to do shit with him. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just always looked up to him and he just kind of like always brought me around. And then the next thing you know, I started skating because I was like, damn, like he's skating. Like I want to skate. Like whatever he was doing, riding dirt bikes, whatever. And then just eventually just got hooked, you know? And I think actually that was right around the time, like when I started skating, was when Tony Hawk did the 900. So that whole thing just kind of blew up and was like, you know, kind of got it sparked up. I'm sure that's for a lot of people too, but you know.
Hell yeah. And do you remember, like your first board and everything you got?
I'm not 100% what my first board was, but I've asked my cousin and I'm pretty sure it was like a World Industries board. It's been so long. It's like 20 something or 20 years, almost 21 years, but.
Damn, 21 years. That's fucking awesome, dude.
Yeah. I'll be 26 in January. So that would be, I guess the 20 year or 21 year.
So yeah. we're gonna have a big old celebration for you for your 21st, you know, 21 year mark, you know?
Yeah, man. that would be sick.
So what was it like skateboarding in Jersey? You know, I mean, because you grew up in Jersey, skated in Jersey, and what was it like there? You know, I mean,
it sucks, you know, but it made me who I am today, and I wouldn't trade that shit, you know, for nothing. I mean, it sucks because it's like, obviously it's not like here. It's like everything's almost perfect, you know, like you go to a schoolyard, you got benches, you got all this shit. But like, I don't know, like growing up there is just like, we just made whatever we had, we would just make do with it and just like try to, you know, just create shit just out of nothing. Like we actually had this, in my hometown, we had this DIY spot called Showroom. Mm-hmm. And like we had like these plastic like Jersey barriers going down like the dirt gaps, like to make like a handrail. And then we would have like these, like it was like, you know, those DIYs where it's like one level and then the lower level, obviously to make like a gap, just skate shit like that. It was a little rough, but you know, it was still, like I said before, I wouldn't trade it for nothing.
Yeah, definitely. And you, I mean, you skated, I mean, the roads on the, I mean, we're both from the East Coast. I'm from the South, you're from the East. I mean, but the roads out on the East and South is like horrible, dude.
Yeah, it's just from, you know, we get snow and then they throw down salt and just salt just eats the fucking ground up. And then next thing you know, like brand new spot that they just had is just like, you fall, you get cheese grated. So, you know.
Oh, that's the worst, dude. Especially in the wintertime, man, when you fucking slam, dude.
Yeah, dude. You feel like your fucking bones are just gonna shatter, like, you know.
Yeah, skating in
30-degree fucking weather. That shit sucks, man.
I mean, growing up in Florida, I mean, like, yeah, I mean, people don't think it gets cold, but it gets fucking cold here, dude. Like, I remember, I grew up in Pensacola, so I mean, I remember times ago skating. We had to put it was like 40 degrees and we're freezing, dude. I had to put like 5 layer of clothes on, socks, this and that, just to stay cool, you know?
Yeah.
Or warm, you know, actually. But yeah, definitely. And you had shops. Did you have a shop that you used to go to all the time?
Yeah.
Or whatever?
There's like a few shops in Jersey, but the one that I always like went to because it was closest to me, and actually I still ride for them, is called Pro Skateboard Shop in Belmar, New Jersey. If anybody's in Jersey, you know, make sure you guys check that out. It's over on like the Central Jersey Shore. It's like Main Street in Belmar. But yeah, like that's what I always went to. There's also like NJ Skate Shop and Travel Skate Shop and a couple other places too. But Pro Skateboard Shop's the one that actually was my first sponsor when I was like 15 or 14.
Okay.
Yeah, they're awesome dudes over there. Bob Lazito, he's the man. Hopefully he's watching this. That'd be cool.
He probably is. He's probably going to text you a little
bit. Yeah.
Thanks for the shout out, bro. Here's a package, man. Represent out in LA.
Yeah, he's tight, man.
Hell yeah. Do you remember? And so that was your first shop sponsor. And did you get like, do you remember your actual real spot, like company sponsor?
My first real like company sponsor. I mean, like I got shop flow for a few things, like when I was back home, you know, when I first like got on the shop, he was like helping me get some shop flow. It was like, I think it was like, when I was like 16, I think it was like DDK and then like Power Peralta for like a little bit and stuff like that. And then Bronson and Richter eventually. But my first like real company sponsor was actually Fortune Skateboards, like Manny's company. I mean, you know, it's no longer right now, but yeah, that was like my first real, like, I guess, you know, sponsor, which was, shout out to Manny, man. It was a good time, so, you know.
Hell yeah, definitely. And then, and making that move from Jersey to LA, what was that like, dude?
It was honestly like probably the hardest, like, decision. You know, it's not easy going across from another side of the country just to, and like not really knowing what to expect and just being on your own for the first time, you know, like I was just couch surfing and shit like that. And like thankfully I had a couple friends that helped me, like, you know, let me stay on their couch, but it was nerve-wracking, you know, just never done anything like that, you know. But it was all worth it, dude. Best, hardest, but most best decision I ever made. And I highly recommend if you guys want to really do something and, like, you know, give it a shot. It's like, come here. It's like, what do you got to lose? Just, you know, everything's worth a try to me. So
yeah, definitely. And that Cali hustle. Tell us about that Cali hustle, man.
Yeah, it's fucking, I don't know, man. You're surrounded by kids who are just fucking unbelievably talented, and it's like you either gotta get with it or just go the fuck home, you know what I mean? Not trying to sound like a dick, but you know.
No, it's true.
Like it's a crazy fucking the level of skating is at, you know, especially coming from the East Coast, it's like it's a whole nother game. These kids are like fucking, like, they're from the womb, they're already skating fucking giant ass bowls and shit like that, kickflip front boarding 15 rails and shit, you know. So it's a lot different, but it's exciting, gets me motivated, wants to skate harder, you know. So
yeah definitely. I mean these kids are popping out. I mean they're playing with tech decks in their mom's wounds, like,
yeah, I know, dude.
They're doing like switch keg grinds on the vein right down here in the stomach, or kickflip over the stomach muscle, you know. But nah, it's definitely crazy, man. Like, you know, Cali, the Cali hustle out there, it's I mean, I lived out there many times, and I plan to go back again, because of all the pandemic and everything that's going on out there. But yeah. But I mean, it is crazy, dude. Like when I first moved out there, I mean, I went out there with like $1,000 and a plane ticket and didn't know anybody out there and like, and made who I am, you know what I mean? Yeah. I'm not trying to say I'm big and famous, but I mean, but just, I had to learn, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah, man, you found like this, you found your happiness, you know what I mean? You found like, you wouldn't even expect, like when you first like were on that plane, you're like, shit, like, you wouldn't have pictured any of the scenarios that, you know, that's going on in your life, the people you've met and shit like that. Like, that's what I was saying before. It's all worth it. You know, like I came here with $2,000 and I ended up blowing it in the first fucking 2 weeks that I got here. And then I got a job and just fucking got to it. You know what I mean? But like I said, I'm just like you, like I'm not famous or whatever, but like, yeah. It's all fucking worth it, man.
And I just agree with you, man. It's 100% worth it, man. Like, I mean, Florida is always gonna be my home, but Cali is always gonna be my second home. I mean, that's where I feel like. I mean, I grew up in Florida, but I feel like I more grew up in Cali. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because I mean, cause going out there, you have to like truly hustle. It's not like what people think. Golden Roads, you're gonna have like all these sponsors and all this money and all that.
Doesn't work like that, man. And I like a lot of people, like they get upset, you know, when shit doesn't happen the way as fast as they want it to. But it's like, you know, I know I was even guilty of that too, because like I was like going all like stressed out, like damn, like, you know, like kind of like worried about the next dude, like damn, like, you know, he has that, like, you know, I feel like I should be getting that. And I was like, I just totally eliminated that thought process, you know. And I was just like, no, dude, like, I'm going to focus on myself and I'm just going to be patient and just work hard. And just, and slowly, like, these opportunities started arising. And I was just like, damn, like, okay, like, all right, I'm on the right track, you know. And just, I'm thankful for that shit, because I've seen a lot of dudes that, like, are really talented and they just let their mind, you know, kind of slip outward, and then they get mad and just like they just want to give up. But it's just like, you know, just gotta fight that shit and keep going, dude, you know, because it'll happen. It's just not your time yet, you know.
Yeah, and you know, we gotta let the universe work its way.
Yeah, dude, for real.
Definitely. And so do you skate with me? Like, what's your favorite thing? Do you like skate more park, or do you like skate more street, or what?
I mean I definitely skate more street. I've always been in the streets, like especially back home in Jersey. Like, that's, you know, well, now they're building more skate parks, but at the time, like especially when I was growing up, we didn't have none of those skate parks, really shitty skate parks to be. But I don't know, man. I love streets. Like, I'll be in the parks when I gotta practice for a contest, or if I'm practicing to try that trick in the streets. You know what I mean? But usually, you know, going back to what Josh was saying, like, dude, like, we go fix spots and then get it ready for the weekend or whatever. Just constantly be in the streets. Like, it's just so, I don't know. Something about being in the streets just feels productive, and like, you know what I mean, with the homies and stuff like that. I love that shit.
Yeah, definitely. I know what you mean, man. It is definitely. I love. I mean, parks are cool. I mean, there's some cool parks, but there's some that are like, I'm not feeling it, man. I feel like I'm at Disneyland or something, you know?
Yeah, like, yeah, I know. Especially when it's fucking packed.
Yeah, definitely. But a bunch of rainbow dudes on BMX. That's the worst. But no, I agree with you, man. I definitely agree. I mean, me personally, I'm a little older, but I mean, I still love the skate and it's in my blood. I mean, I don't do as much as I used to, but I think about it every day. You know what I mean? I'll be driving or something. I'll just have tricks in my head, or like, I'll practice tricks on my steering wheel and stuff like that. But when I do get a chance to go skate, I prefer skating some flat ground out front of the house, or, you know, some, go to the local curb and just sesh on there. You know, I'm not trying to jump down and be the next old pro skater, you know.
I mean there's some times where we get to park and like super crowded, and I'll just say fuck it, I'll just, you know, just kind of dodge everybody as I'm going. But like, as I'm getting older, like, I mean, I'm only 25, but I'm like more of like, all right, let's get it early sesh or evening sesh, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. That's I just, like I said before, I'd rather the streets. I'd rather the streets. It's me and my friends and not dealing with nothing but
having
fun and trying to get some bangers, you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. And then what's your day like? What's your daily life like every day you wake up, you know, from the time you wake up to the time you go to sleep?
Well, I wake up, I have to like chill for an hour, drink my coffee and just like mentally prep myself for the day. But yeah, I've just been actually, since I've been back from Jersey not too long ago, like I've just been going, like Manny lives right up the street from me, Manny Santiago, and like I just go over to his crib, we fucking work out and then go skate and then chill, relax, and then skate in the evening again, and then, or maybe go fix a spot or just get shit ready. We kind of been on a mission of just trying to stack clips. So that's basically what I've been doing every day. Just wake up, work out, skate, chill, relax, skate again, and then just go right back to fucking sleep and do it all over again.
Hey, that's a good, great day, man.
Yeah, dude, it's awesome, man. I'm blessed, and it's probably going to change a little bit because my girl's still in Jersey right now. So once she gets back, her team's going to have to stop.
So when she comes back,
or at least slow down a little bit, not stop, you know.
So when she comes back, it's going to be like, oh, shit, I can't skate every day. Fuck, I got to do this and this.
Yeah. That's life, and, you know, that's it. You know, I love her, though. She knows I'm probably joking if she's watching this.
She probably is watching. She's like, I'm gonna get on to him this.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And do you have any good memories hanging out or skating with Manny or anything like that, like, or when you were on the team and stuff?
Yeah. I mean, he would take, like, we'd go up to Woodward and shit. You know, because he would like be a guest pro and stuff like that. We went up to Woodward one time. We went on like a skate camping trip up to, I think it was somewhere by Santa Barbara, I'm pretty sure, or like those mountains over there. But I don't know, man. Just like just being with him is like fucking awesome. You know, I grew up watching him too, so it's like, it's an honor to be rolling with him and consider him like one of my good ass friends now. So, but actually yesterday was probably one of the most memorable days, I would say, because I ended up getting my ender for this new part I'm working on with Fallen, and just to have him there and like, you know what I mean? Like he was towing me in and shit too. So it was like, it's definitely one for the books, you know?
Yeah, definitely. And is Manny, like, you feel Manny's like your more mentor? Not mentor, but like more inspires you to skate?
Yeah, so definitely.
Pushes away better, you know?
Yeah, like, dude, like, this guy works fucking hard. Like he just turned 35 a couple of days ago, and like, this dude is just on a mission. Like, his work ethic is insane, and like, I just want to be surrounded by people who want to work as hard, you know? Because it pushes me, like, you know, to see somebody who's 10 years older than me still just fucking gunning for it. So, like, there's his foot's fully on the gas pedal, you know what I mean? So yeah. It's awesome to see that shit. And I'm stoked to be, like, be his friend and be able to, you know, get that same work ethic in. So.
Hell yeah. And another question, too, other than, you know, who's your sponsors?
As of right now, my sponsors is Pro Skateboard Shop, Destructo Trucks, Fallen Footwear, Highland Pico, Arcade Belts, Remind Insoles, and Nanocraft CBD. And yeah, so that's what's going on right now. I don't think I missed anybody. I think that's all of them, but yeah. I know right now, like, that's, you know, there's couple other things that I'm still on edge with, but we're just not sure of how. Oh, and I'm sorry, this is a new one, Grizzly Grip Tape. I will not forget that. That's a new one that just happened, and gonna be working on something with them soon too. So really stoked on that as well.
Hell yeah, dude. That's sick, dude. That's some good lineup sponsors you got there, dude. Like, damn.
Thank you, man. Thank you. I'm blessed, dude, for real.
Hell yeah, dude. And do you have anything, you know, like, coming up, something that, you know, the audience or the, you know, skaters can look forward for? So, like, new video part or
something? Yeah. Yeah, I actually have I think it might drop at the end of October. I'm not sure yet, but I'll have my new Welcome to Fallen Park come out. So that's definitely something you guys should be looking forward to. And I can't wait to fucking show everybody, man. It's been fucking grinding for that one. So hopefully everybody enjoys it.
Hell yeah. I can't wait to see that either too, man. And you know, we got your back, so we'd be down to help promote it.
Dude, thank you, man. I'll keep you guys in the loop for sure.
Oh yeah, and do you have anything you want to say to like upcoming skaters or anything at all?
Yeah, just you know, stay humble and just know that whatever the work that you want to put in is what you're gonna get out. You know, don't expect skateboarding to owe you shit, and just keep doing it because you love to do it. Don't do it just because you want to have money. You know what I mean? Like, that shit can come later, but just fucking keep grinding and just don't let nobody stop you, dude. Not family, not friends, not girlfriends, none of that shit. Do your thing.
I agree on that.
Yeah.
I definitely agree on that, man. Well, Devo, man, yeah, I'm so proud of you, dude. Like, you're killing it, dude. Like, you know, I see your clips on Instagram. Oh, by the way, where can people find you on Instagram?
You can find me at D-E-E underscore B-O. Yeah.
Okay. And do you have like a YouTube channel or anything?
I do actually. It's just my name, Dave Bohack. But I might actually also have a Woodward montage coming out that me and the homies went up north for. It'd either be on my YouTube channel. If not, you can find the link on my Instagram. So be sure to check that out too. Dude, thanks for having me, bro. Really appreciate it.
No problem, Devo. And thank you so much, man. And I wish you the best of luck in anything you do, man, because you're an amazing person and amazing skater too. And thank you, I'm fucking proud to sit down with you and have this conversation with you and stuff.
Thanks,
and I just want to say real quick, thank you to everybody coming on the show. Want to thank all of our sponsors. The next show that's coming up will be October, episode 7. We're going to have a great one for you. And you guys ready to check out Gene's newest song?
Hell yeah, dude. Dude, that was sick.
Hell yeah, dude.
That was great. And so was Josh's part. He's got some mean switch heels.
Yes, he does, dude. Josh's part is sick. Coming up is Gene's song. Let's check it out.
I don't know, might be wrong.
Yeah, so do you guys want to redo the first half or no?
Honestly, I kind of have to flex.